Following occupation, all members of the platoon will have their Bergens removed and will be lying in the position allocated to them by the section commander during occupation. They will be on top of the Bergens with their rifles pointing out. At this stage, the platoon commander will order clearance patrols to be carried out. Clearance patrols will depart via their neighbouring section apex, and they will patrol out, covering that section's arcs to the limits of sight and sound. They will return through their own apex and report to the platoon commander. They will be looking out for signs of enemy occupation and anything else that may make the platoon harbour unsuitable. To demonstrate this, I'll use 3 Section as an example. The two members from 3 Section will depart via the 1 Section apex. They will patrol out to the limit of sight and sound, and they will return in through their own apex. When they return, they will then report to the platoon HQ. Once the platoon commander is happy that all 3 clearance patrols have been conducted and the site is indeed suitable, they will then order sentries to be posted. To recap what we've covered so far, I've set out a representative triangular harbour in the area behind me. At this stage, the section commander has completed their final recce and they have checked communications. They will send back the runner with one of the section commanders to report to the platoon sergeant in the snap ambush. There, they will be guided in a single file led by the section commander that has been on the recce. The platoon will enter by the 6 o'clock apex. This is 1 section. They will be met by 1 section commander. The rest of the platoon will also follow in single file. With 1 section, the section commander will already have allocated basher positions, and when the section arrives, will show them where that position is and will allocate the marks of fire. As the rest of the section comes through, 2 section will then be met at the 2 section apex by their commander. The same thing will happen. Basher positions and arcs of fire will be allocated. Finally, 3 section, who have now walked behind 1 section positions and through 2 section positions, will be met by the 3 section commander. There, they will have basher positions and arcs allocated. The HQ element will have gone into the centre of the harbour to be met by the platoon commander. At this stage, the platoon will have removed their Bergens and will be lying in the positions allocated by their section commander upon occupation. When ready, the platoon commander will order that clearance patrols take place. Once clearance patrols have returned and the platoon commander is happy, they will order sentries to be posted. Sentries act as a form of early warning upon enemy advance towards the patrol harbour. At night time, they will be close in and they will be double manned at the apex or corner of each section position. During the day, they will be pushed out further to the limit of noise to avoid distraction from the work routine. A form of communication will be set up between the sentries and the patrol harbour itself. This is typically in the form of a communications cord or string. That string will go from the sentry position to the section or into the platoon HQ. It will be used as a silent form of alerting the platoon HQ in the event of an enemy approach. With sentries now posted, the platoon commander can order the platoon to stand down. They can now start work routine. As part of that work routine, a track plan will be established around the inside of the patrol harbour. This can also have a communications cord or an inner wire. The purpose of this is so the platoon can navigate around the harbour at night or in complete darkness and in silence. Other tasks that are now being carried out. The platoon commander may be receiving and issuing further orders. Individuals within the sections will be conducting their own work routine. They'll be clearing areas, and just as darkness falls, they'll be erecting their bashes. They will be conducting personal admin, they will be washing, they will be eating, they will be cleaning their weapons, they will be sleeping, and they will be preparing for future patrols. It's most likely that just before daybreak, the section will be up, bashes will be collapsed, and the platoon will be ready to move out. I hope you found this lesson on patrol harbours interesting. Remember, this is just the beginning. You need to practice with a section and with a platoon. It's every member's responsibility to understand what their roles and responsibilities are when occupying a patrol harbour, and their conduct and their work routine once they get into the patrol harbour. Remember, there are 5 stages: selection, occupation, clearance patrols, sentries, and work routine. Hopefully now you can undertake the knowledge check at the bottom of this page. Thank you for watching.